Welcome to Center for Online Education. Friends, today we are going to discuss another paper in MCOM and MBA. In MCOM, it has been taken in the third semester and the fourth semester. It is paper number 304 and 305. And in MBA, it has been taken into MBA 2.2 in the second semester. The name of the paper is the Production Management. And today we are going to explore the various impact and the various dimensions of the production management. Now, let's understand that what is the production system. System is a regularly interacting interdependent group of items forming a unified whole. Means a system has got different points, different people, different aspect, and we have to combine that aspect and make it in a unified area to make that work properly, productive and effective. Now, elements of production system. Now, as I have told you that it is a combination of different elements. So, what are the elements? The first one is input. Input means whatever we are going to put in the system is known as the input. Input are the physical and human resources utilized in the process of production. They consist of raw material, parts, capital equipments, human efforts, etc. Means whenever we are talking about the production system, we are talking about the human resources, the people who are working for there, the raw material, the finished good, everything, the warehouses, the equipment which we are going to use, everything is being considered over here. The second one is the conversion process. Conversion process is very important. Input process. Now, whatever you are going to put inside the system, it is going to be processed. And this process is known as the conversion process, converging the input into output. So here it refers to the series of operations which are performed on materials and part. Now, if you are constructing a house, there are different raw materials, like you have to take sand, you have to take cement, you have to take bricks, water, everything. And you have got manpower, labors, and according to that, you have to get the process. They are going to construct the house to get the final output of a big house. Now, outputs. Outputs are the products of completed parts resulting from the conversion process. Output generates revenue. As I have told you that if you are going to keep the sand, cement, water, everything into different parts, it is not going to give you revenue. So you have to get it processed. And by the process of the system, you are going to construct a house or a industry or a factory. And on the basis of that factory, you are going to generate the revenue. Then storage. Storage that takes after the receipt of inputs between one operations and the other operation to be performed. Means where you are going to keep the inputs, where you are going to keep the final product. So here the storage is very important. Somewhere or the other, warehouse is a place where we used to keep the things, whether it is input product or whether it is the final product. Transportation. Inputs are transported from one operation to another operation in the product process. So, if you are going to get a production system, it is very important that you have to carry the raw material from one place to another place. So, transportation is being required. So, whether it is being done by the manpower, whether it is being done in the automated process, whether it is being done by the different lorries, tractors, trolleys, trucks, it must be taken into action. The top management must decide that what are the transportation process which must be considered. Then information. It is the vital element. It is the blood of all the production system, because whatever you are going to input and what output you are going to get, it depends upon the information process. As you all know that if you are constructing a house, it's the labor who is going to tell you that this much of sand you require, this much of cement you are required, and according to that you are going to buy it. Means it is an informational process which is being given from a skilled person to a person who has to buy it. So here information is very important for any production system to be successful. Types of production system. There are two types of production system which is being generally found in our country. The first one is flow or continuous system, and the second one is intermittent production system. Flow or continuous production system, by its name, says that it is a process which is being accepted when we are going to make the product which is being generally required in the market, and the process is being continuously followed. While intermittent process is being only applied when we are going to produce a product on the basis of the customer's order. Means every time we are going to get the order of a person, we are going to match this much of quality and we are going to produce it in the market. Now, flow or continuous system. Let's understand that what is a flow or continuous system. The continuous flow production situations are those where the facilities are standardized as to routine and the flow since inputs are standardized. Therefore, there are a standard set of process and sequence of the process can be adopted. Means it is a sequence of process. We are going to take it into action and A machine is going to do whatever the finished product will be taken into B machine and the finished product of the B machine is going to be taken into C machine. Accordingly, the final product is going to come out. And when we take this into consideration, we say that we are following the continuous system. What are the characteristics of continuous system? The first one is the volume of output is generally large. That is, it has been done in the mass production. As I have told you, that it depends upon the market. So mass production has been required over here and goods are produced in anticipation of the demand. Means when there is a demand, we are going to make the product. The product design and the operation sequence are standardized. That is, identical products are produced. Means if you see the toothpaste, there are different types of companies who are producing the toothpaste. And according to the demand of the product, we are going to make the toothpaste and we are going to present that toothpaste in the market. A special purpose, automatic machines are used to perform standardized operations. As it is a continuous process, it depends upon the demand of the market. So there must be an automated system which continuously works to get the supply maintained in the market. Machines' capacities are balanced so that materials are fed at one end of the process and the finished product is received at the other end. Means there must be a balance between the input and the output. Each machine must be properly utilized so that there must be a continuous flow of product and there must be minimum waste and best output. Optimum utilization of resources can be properly made. Fixed path materials handling equipment is used due to the predetermined sequence of the operations. As you all know that it is a continuous process, the machines which are being planted over here are being planted into sequence of order. As I have told you, A, B, C, D, E, F. So here, whenever the product of A is being completed, then it is being put into the B machine. So there must be a transportation process which will tap into mine while taking the continuous process. Product layout designed according to the separate line for each product is considered. Means for each product, there is a product line and we have to maintain that product line for the best output. Now, merits or advantages of continuous flow system. The main advantage of continuous system is that it works in the progress of inventory is minimum. As you all know that, as I have told you, it is a continuous process. It depends upon the demand of the market. So it is very important that it requires a minimum inventory because whatever you are producing, you are directly supplying to the market. The quality of output is kept uniform because each stage develops skills through repetition of work. Means as each machine is being repetitive his own work, so here all the human resource, all the manpower knows that what type of work he has to perform. And when their skills are being done in a same work, they are going to enhance their skills. So the quality of the product is very good. Any delay at the stage is automatically detected. Means, as I have told you, there are different machines who are performing at the same time. Any delay in machine is going to affect the another machine. So any problem can easily be detected in the continuous system. Handling of material is reduced due to the set pattern of production line. Mostly the materials are handled through conveyor belts, roller conveyors, pipelines, overhead trains, etc. As I have told you that there are sequence of machines, there are sequence of chains which we are going to take into action in the continuous system. So the production of one machine depends on the production of another machine. So these are the things which is being required so that input of the one machine is not being affected by the output of another machine. Control over material, cost and output is simplified. As you all know that we are going to put the raw material in the first machine and after several machines the output is going to come. So here in this system, in the continuous system, there must be a simplified
costing system, simplified material system, simplified inventory system. The work can be done by semi-skilled worker because of their specialization. As each worker has to perform a routine activity for each machine, so the skill required by each worker is somewhat minimum, because he is going to do the same work. And if he is going to same work every day, his competency is automatically going to increase and he is going to be skilled one day. Now, what are the demerits or disadvantages of the continuous system? First one, very rigid, and there is a fault in one operation, the entire process is disturbed. As I have told you that it depends upon the sequence or the chain of different machines. If any of the one machines in the mid is going to be affected, the process of another machine. For example, A, B, C, D, four machines are working randomly. And if we have got any problem in machine C or machine V, automatically whole process is going to be affected, because here machine A is working and machine B is working, but the output of the machine B is being affected, so it cannot go to the machine C, and automatically whole process is going to be affected. Unless the fault is cleared immediately, it will force the proceeding as well as the subsequent stage obviously stopped. As you all know that if machine B is being stopped, automatically there is a problem, that because machine A is working, so the input of the machine A is going to be converted into final product of the machine B. But machine B is being affected, so here all the machines after machine B is also being affected, because they are not going to do the work unless and until machine B is going to affect or produce the product. So it must be properly taken into care, and the fault must be detected in time and must be taken into consideration. It is essential to maintain standby equipment to meet any breakdowns resulting in the production stoppage. Thus, investment in machines are fairly high. Here, for each and every machines, we must have to maintain certain equipments. And for maintaining that certain equipments, we required the certain investment. So, for maintaining a continuous process, the inventory charges or the equipment charges are high. Therefore, whole process is somewhat much more expensive than the other one. Now, types of continuous production. There are three types of continuous production: mass production, process production, assembly line. Mass production, whenever we are going to make any product which is being needed in the market in a majority of things. For example, I have taken the example of the toothpaste. It is a mass required in the mass. Each and everyone is going to require the toothpaste. So when we talk about this type of product, it comes into mass production. The second one is process production. Process production means there is a certain stimuli. There are certain products which is being required from one company to another company. For all the soft drinks producer, you require a bottle. So any company who is making a bottle is being the subsidiary company of the company who is making the soft drink. So here process is being required. So the process of making the bottles depends upon the demand of the soft drink company. Now, assembly line. Assembly line means there are certain things. For example, if you are going to buy a mobile phone, your computer, there are different ICs which is being made. So according to that assembly line, we are going to make our product. And this makes the assembly line system. Now let's explore another method that is known as intermittent production method. Intermittent situations are those where the facilities must be flexible enough to handle a variety of products and size, or where the basic nature of the activity imposes change on important characteristics of the input, change in the product design. So here, whatever we are going to take, it depends upon the order which we are going to get them the market. So here companies are only going to produce the product when they are having an advanced order from the customer. As you have seen that there are medicines, and in each medicine there is a batch number. So what is this batch number? Means that this much is being required by this specific area. So they have given a specific batch number. All the generic medicines which are going to be produced in the for the North UP, it has got different batch number. For South UP, it is being different batch number. For Maharashtra, it will be a different batch number. So here, the product is being made when the order is being got by the customer. Now, what are the characteristics of the intermittent production system? The flow of production in intermittent not continuous. It is not a continuous process. It is only being taken out when the order is being received. The volume of production is generally small. As you all know that the products which we are made over here has got an expiry dates. So the order is being made on the basis of the demand which is in the market. A wide variety of products are produced. You can make as the order is being changed or it is being depends upon the customer's demand. So there can be a variety of product can be made. General purpose machines and equipments are used to be adapted in a wide variety of operations. Means here you require less types of machines because the machines can be easily transformed from one to another for the intermittent production system. No single sequence of operation is used and periodically adjustments are made to suit different jobs or batches. So here there is no setup of chain. As per the demand, we used to take the help of the different machines and accordingly we make the product. Process layout is most suited. Means here instead of plant layout, there must be a process layout which is being suited. As you know, if you are going to make medicines, you different raw material, then you have to process it, then you have to pack it, then you have to send it. So here, process layout is required in the intermittent system. Now, types of intermittent process, job production and batch production. Job production means as per the need of the job, we are going to produce the product. For example, when you are celebrating any birthday party, you are going to require cake. So every year on a specific date, you are going to require a cake. So what is job over here? You are celebrating a party and for that party, you are required certain things. So for that certain things, you are going to hire a certain person who is an event manager and he is going to collect everything for that party and bring to a specific place and the party is going to be organized. So when this type of production process has been considered, it is known as being the job production. Now the batch production is what? When there is certain products which is being made on the basis of specific geographical area, we say it is being done on the batch production. Now, comparison of different production system. As I have told you, there are two systems. Now, let's compare that what is the difference between the two systems. Continuous system, flow system is better or intermittent system is better. So, manufacturing cost, as you know that continuous system is a very big system. You required a different types of machines. You required transportation. You required a different equipment that no flaws can be accepted in the production process. Therefore, in continuous flow production system, our investment is more as compared to the intermittent system. Second, size and capital investment. Intermittent system can be made in a smaller area with a less cost of investment, while continuous system requires a big area and a heavy investment. Flexibility in production. Continuous system is more of a rigid system, while intermittent system is more of a flexible system. Required technical ability. Both the system require the technical ability as the final product has the certain standard qualities. And for maintaining that qualities, you require the skilled human resource as well as the standard inventories, raw materials. Everything must be in the quality and standardized form. So here, in both the form, you require the technical ability. Organizational structure. For continuous system, you have to set a big organizational structure because for each machines, you have to get a simple and specific manpower having skilled to operate that specific machine. While in the intermittent system, as you know that works depend on the process system. So a worker can do a job in the different machines. So here manpower required is less than the continuous system. Then job security. In continuous system, it is more of a secure job. Why? Because you required a skilled worker in each and every machines. While in intermittent system, a man can perform his duty in the different machines at a specific time. So here in the intermittent system, the job security is less. In the continuous system, the job security is more. Industrial application. When we talk about the big industry, we required flow or continuous system. When we talk about the smaller companies, smaller organizations, or we talk about the subsidiaries companies, intermittent system is being taken into consideration. So these are the comparison on which the two system is being required. If a person is going to start a business and he is going to do a business for the small scale, medium scale, he is going to follow the intermittent system, while for industries and heavy industries, you have to go with the flow or continuous system. So I hope that these are the points which we have taken into consideration are very useful for you, and it will help you to understand about the production management. Thank you.